Welcome back to the channel. So today I'm going to be showing you some. Okay. Oh gosh. Some clothing hacks. Okay. So I have a little extra hack. Yes, everything made it in. I'm going to show you how to like. Let's just say like you're sewing something, right? That's clothing related, right? Let's just say like you're sewing something and then you're like, ow! I poked myself with a needle. I've done it before. Yeah. Sewing point shoes is like, ugh. Man. But basically, usually if you put it on like the tip of your finger, you'd put it like, wow, Kaylin. You know, every single time. Okay. It worked. But you're usually gonna put it like this, right? Now I actually didn't poke my finger, so there's no like puncture wound. So you'd usually like put it like this, and you're like, yay, you know? But like this thing, bro, it doesn't stay on there. So I also got this from 5 Minute Crafts. If you haven't seen part one to this video, but I just saw it, and I'm not saying it originated from there because I've seen it in a ton of places. But this is just where I decided to get it. Please don't cringe at this. I know, I'm sorry. But basically, I should have gotten scissors. Kaylin. Okay. So basically you're gonna take some scissors, right? And then you're gonna cut this area in half and do the same on the other side. Just like this. So then let's just say, ow, I poked myself. Then you can do it like this. So put it there, right? And then you just take this one. Maybe I should have cut deeper. Okay, take this one. Why am I talking to you like I know what I'm doing? I don't really know what I'm doing, but okay. I think you actually have to like cut really over there. Okay, so cut. Then take, come on, cooperate. Take this one, then take this one, and then take this one. You guys kind of get the idea, right? I didn't do a very good job of it, but It's okay. But you guys get the idea, right? So it actually works. I'm pretty sure it actually works that it stays on secure because it just latches on tighter. You know what I'm saying? It's just like this instead of like this. So I'm pretty sure it works, okay? I just needed better execution and that didn't happen. I apologize. Hey, guys, have you guys ever like realized this? So this happened in like fourth grade and I was like, you know, bleeding and I put a bandaid on my finger and then I spilled water on like this one of these things that came on the band-aid, you know, like this thing. So let me just show you what I mean. It is so crazy. It is so weird. Okay, so I'm just gonna take a little bit of water. This is actually kind of messy. I'm sorry because I'm gonna have to wipe up this water later, but look, this is so off topic, but I'm just gonna pour some water because I spilled some water. Oops, I spilled some water. And then I put this on here and literally, at least for like the Band-Aid brand that I was using, it like slowly curling up. Look at that. It's like actually curling up. Why does it do that? Can anybody tell me why it does that? And if like you do it with regular paper, that doesn't happen with regular paper. Anyway, okay, so yeah, I don't understand why that happens. And if anybody could like explain it to me in the comments, just explain it to me, please. Cause I honestly just don't know. But now I gotta go clean up this mess. Hooray. So here is the next hack. That was so awkward, but here's the next hack. And basically what it is folding socks. So this is how my family folds socks. These are a couple of my dad's socks. So anyway. So these are how we fold socks normally, and it works. Like, you know, if you just want to go to your drawer and just do like sock, you know. But if you want a more organized look, because this isn't very organized, you know, I gotta just say that. So you want a more organized look, I did this with my dad's sock drawer the other day, and it worked so well. Like, it looked so good. So let me just show you what I did, okay? So basically, this is what happened. I spread the socks out like this. Then went like that, right? And then basically, I think, yes, okay. I just like folded it until I thought it could stand up straight. See, like that, you know? And so what I did was I arranged my dad's socks from like light to dark. So yeah, so once things like stand up straighter, you can also like conserve more space. I think that's like the Anne Marie Kondo way, if I believe it. That, yeah, so I just kind of like to roll it up until it can stand straight by itself. And then once you like roll all these together, it looks like so nice. You just gotta be sure that you just grasp it so you don't just go like, and then everything just uncurls. So basically just grab the top and it should work out. But yeah, oh, that one wasn't as good, but it's okay. So try to put like these two together. Here's some more examples. I could be folding it neater, but I'm, you know. Hello? Thank you. So, it doesn't take very long, depending on how nice you want it to look, but it works with all sock sizes, as you just saw with some shorter socks. It also works with lady socks, I mean, obviously, not just men's socks. But, yeah, so it definitely works. And now you just have like just five pairs of socks just there. And whenever you want to, you just go ahead and just go like, there it is. And then you just like, I just found my socks now. And so I already said this, right? Whenever it stands up straight vertically, it conserves more space. So yeah, now your sock drawer looks like more organized and stuff, which is great. Yeah! Boom. On to the next hack. I did not dab, okay?
Okay. Yep, that works.
Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, so, hey! Okay, so I'm gonna be showing you how to like stuff clothes in a sock. Okay, that sounds so awkward, but I'm sure there's better ways to like transport clothes in like a more, but I just wanted to try it because it looked really interesting, and so yeah, so let's just try it. So at first, we are going to be using a slightly larger shirt. And yes, this is Olaf. Say hi. It's Olaf! But yeah, this is one of the largest shirts I own. So obviously the larger the shirt, the larger the sock, I'm pretty sure. So it can fit in there better. So you're basically gonna spread Olaf out. Hey Olaf, how you doing? Yeah, what's up? Okay, then you can put like whatever you want inside. So I'm just going with these pair of shorts in here, right? And then right after you finish doing that, you're gonna put one of the socks, only one, and to here. You want to make sure everything's relatively flat. Cool. So then we are basically going to fold this all in half. Okay. Okay, and this is the important part, okay? Make sure, okay, that's good. So make sure you roll this up really tightly, because the tighter you roll it, the easier it'll be, like the smaller it is, so it'll be able to like fit into the sock better. Okay, so I'm rolling it really tight. Okay, and that is it. That is my bundle. I guess you could just transport it like that, you know, put two socks inside instead of one. But now, you're gonna turn the sock inside out. You'll see why for a second. Then do this. So now your hands is just like randomly inside this sock, which is kind of weird. Wait, where did all this fuzz come from? Did the sock do that? Oh gosh. So now, sorry about that. But now we're just gonna take it, grasp the end. It's like the hardest part. I don't like this part. But, and then we're just gonna like start inverting the sock over it. Come on, don't become unrolled. Like I said, there's probably easier ways to do this. But, yeah. Oh, okay. Okay, I see you. Uh-huh. Okay, now you just wanna fully invert the sock. And that's how you do it with a larger shirt. Obviously, this is a larger sock, so it was a lot easier to put inside because I tried a smaller sock before and literally it was like really hard. But so this is the package inside the larger sock. Yeah! Okay, so sparkles, sparkles, love sparkles. Anyway, so this is a smaller shirt and I have some shorts that I don't even wear, but they're black. So unnecessary. Oh, Mr. Dog, hi. You're getting your camera time, you know?
You mean on YouTube?
Okay, anyway, so I also have some smaller socks. Oh, gotta put that sock in there. Okay. Yes, looks nice. Okay, fold in half, smooth out. Now roll really tight, like rolling a sushi roll. Wait, is this how you roll sushi? I don't know. I've never really made sushi before. Anyway, so inverted sock. It's a sock puppet. Wait, that's not how you do it. Okay, let's try again. Hello. This is the worst sock puppet ever. Okay, ready? Hello, my name is Pink Sock. How you doing today? So like, how's the weather, you know? Like is it morning in there? Or is it like night for you? I just want to know how you're doing. Okay, bye. So awkward, why did I do that? Okay, anyway. So, we're just gonna grasp it, invert the sock. Wait, why is there, it took off the rubber band from my wrist. Thank you. I know you just really like that rubber band, but you could have just asked for it instead of just took it off my hand, but that works too, you know? So, it is a smaller sock, so it's a little bit harder to get everything in, but that's okay. It still works. So you just want to make it. So as you can see, I still have a lot of extra socks, so I can just pull that down, if I can. Because I don't think it's working right now. Like, come on. Well, the point is to get... So I finished stuffing the sock, and this is how it looks like. So this hack is like truly great because, honestly, I went to gym once, right? So I do know that sometimes you're like rooting around in your bag for like your shirt or like your shorts, and then you're like, I can't find it, you know? But like if you use this hack, everything is inside the sock. So it saves a lot of space and saves a pretty decent amount of time. So yeah, I think it's a great hack. But yeah, so those are all the hacks that I have today. I probably said yeah like 5 times in like 1 minute. But anyway, so yeah, again, peace out.